A birthday celebration for Prince Siegfried's coming of age is being prepared by his friend Benno. The prince arrives and is soon enjoying himself. Unexpectedly, the queen mother enters. She takes her son aside and tells him he must give up such frivolous pleasures and assume the responsibilities of the kingdom. The time has come when he must marry. His mother insists that he choose a bride from among the young noble women at the ball. As the sun sets and his friends disperse, he is left alone. Benno returns and tries to distract him. A flock of swans flies overhead. Benno suggests they go to hunt them. Prince Siegfried agrees. Wandering alone deep in the forest, Prince Siegfried sees a swan and prepares to shoot. Suddenly, before his eyes, the swan is transformed into a beautiful maiden, Odette. Never before has his heart been given to anyone, but without hesitation, he offers it to Odette, and she responds. The hovering evil sorcerer, who has enchanted Odette and the other maidens, senses danger. The spell that keeps them swans by day and maidens only by night can be broken if a man who has never loved before swears eternal fidelity to Odette, the queen of the swans. She desperately tries to warn Siegfried of the harm that the sorcerer will bring to them, but in vain. Siegfried and Odette are now deeply in love, though she knows that her fate is already determined. The sorcerer is calling them away. Odette returns for a last farewell. Siegfried declares his love and swears to be faithful forever, and Odette accepts his oath. Finally, she is forced to follow the others. Siegfried is left alone in the ecstasy of his love. Behind him, though the sorcerer looms, plotting the death of the man who threatens his power.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
The guests are arriving for the formal ball to celebrate Prince Siegfried's forthcoming engagement. The Queen Mother arrives and is disturbed to find that Siegfried is not there. Siegfried appears, but his thoughts are still by the lakeside with Odette. The prospective brides are presented to the court by three knights. It is now time for the prince's decision. Despite his mother's insistence, Siegfried refuses to choose. At this moment, a black knight appears, escorting a beautiful woman, Odile. He is the sorcerer, Rothbart, who has taken on human form. Prince Siegfried is enchanted. In his eyes, Odile seems to be his beloved Odette. Siegfried is totally convinced that Odile must be his bride. But Rothbart demands that the prince swear his fidelity. Siegfried willingly does so. Before the prince's eyes, a vision of Odette appears. The spell that deceived him is broken, but it is too late. There is chaos in the ballroom as Siegfried, heartbroken, runs out to find Odette to ask her forgiveness. At the lakeside, Odette tells her maidens that she has been betrayed. Feeding on her anguish, the sorcerer begins to raise a storm. Siegfried rushes in. The Swan maidens, trying to protect Odette, conceal her from him. But eventually he finds her, and in despair begs her forgiveness. In spite of her sorrow, she grants it, but the sorcerer separates them. In a frenzy, Siegfried tries to go after her, but the sorcerer drives the Swan maidens to block his path, trying to force him to his death in the lake. Siegfried eventually collapses by the water. Odette's love gives her the strength to reach Siegfried's side. The sorcerer, intent only on destroying Siegfried, uses his growing rage to feed the storm. The waters of the lake are rising. Odette knows that there is a way to break the enchantment and defeat the sorcerer. She must sacrifice herself. Siegfried wants only to be with her forever. Together, they are overwhelmed by waves. The storm raised to destroy Siegfried has doomed its creator. With the death of the sorcerer, peace returns to the glade. In a vision, Odette and Siegfried united approach the glory of an ideal and eternal love.
Thank you. We'll be right back.